clue. Testing, 1, 2, testing. Hello. Hello. Going to upload a video to YouTube. Hello. Stream delays about quite a lot, about a minute. So I just thought I'd do a test train sim stream. So hopefully, everything will go to plan. You can see my own streams on there. That's funny because I'm streaming my own video to YouTube. Anyway. Hopefully we'll get a few viewers as well. Put the game title in as well. Come up with moderating live chat. We'll probably be lucky to get anyone in the live chat. This is the first stream. I've not streamed on YouTube before. I did stream once on Stream Language English on Twitch, but barely anyone watched, so. Recording date today. Title and description, language English, stream language English, stream location. I'll leave that. Closed captions. I'll put those on. Maybe some people might find those useful. Right, so I've got OBS Studio. So that's uploading now, so I'll open up TrainSim Classic and hopefully it works alright. Actually no, I'm not, I probably shouldn't upload a video, be uploading a video to YouTube while streaming, because that's going to affect my upload speed, or my upload speed is extremely slow anyway, so. Damn it, I shouldn't have done that. I'm going to have to cancel the upload now. Taking forever to load as usual. So do apologise for the delay. We should be up in about 10 minutes or so. Hopefully when I start actually driving a train, I'll get some viewers. Hopefully it doesn't freeze on the menu screen like it does sometimes. Right, okay, let's cancel that. Cancel upload. Go. Okay. It says I've got one viewer, but that's me because I'm watching my own stream. I think we might do a run on the Let's try to the class 121 bubble car. Because I've never driven that before. So let's give that a go. When it loads, never streamed on YouTube, so no idea how many views I'm gonna get. take about 5 million years to load. I don't know with Train Simulator. It seems to be very slow at loading recently. Seems the more DLC you put on there, the slower it is. So this is a class 121 bubble car. It's a single unit. It's like the precursor to the 153. So branch lines under operation of the one class 121 shuttles are dwindling fast. Take one of the last remaining bubble cars down to Paddington, then back down to West Ealing. This service is Greenford bound, but you are not certified to use this branch line. Another driver will take over. So this is on the Great Western Mainline route, which is quite an old route. Sounds like a bus, doesn't it? So yeah, this is like the predecessor to the class 153, which is also which is like a sprinter train with a single unit. And there comes another one. So this is on the Great Western Main Line, which is quite an old route. That's going to Greenford. So yeah, obviously these aren't in service anymore. Right. Never driven this train before, so hopefully it's not too complicated. Wipers. Setting for the wipers to forward. It's got gears as well. Let's open the doors, let the passengers on. So it's got a passenger view as well. There's a HST there. Quality is not going to be very good because of my upload speed. It's very slow, so I'll try not to move the camera too much. Whenever it does, it gets very blocky and pixelated. Got some lights on as well. Alright, it's got gears as well, so I'll move to gear 1. Release the brakes and let's go. Nice passenger view. Next station's Ealing Broadway. Quarters of a mile, so not very far to go. It's kind of like a little bus, isn't it? Or like a predecessor to the 153 or the Pacer. Class 101, it's got gears that you have to change. There's a 166 there. Let's see what the horn sounds like. Come on, brakes. Vacuum brakes, the old-fashioned vacuum brakes, which take a while to kick in. And again, nice smooth stop. Does sound like an old bus, doesn't it? Like a predecessor to the Pacer or the Class 153. Brakes. next save. Right, let's go to our next stop. Put the throttle down to. I won't do that. Speed stops increasing, that's when you want to go up a gear. Stop is at the mainline in 0.9 of a mile. It's got no one watching at the moment, hopefully that will change soon. Otherwise I'll just be talking to myself, but even if no one watches the stream live, the video will still be on here, so not all will be lost. Braking now would be a good idea. Vacuum brakes, you go to apply and you select how much and the braking force will continue, and then until you go to the hold position, and when you want to release your brakes you have to go to release. So, a bit more complicated than the step brake system we're used to in modern trains today. Just to give us a nice smooth stop for the passengers. Task failed? How did I fail? Doors aren't opening. Are we meant to stop here? Maybe we weren't meant to stop here. Never mind, let's just go back to so going to London Paddington, then back down the same way we came. Okay, so we can continue. Don't know what max speed of this thing is. speedometer goes to 70 miles an hour, so it's not fast really. It probably only does about 60, 70 miles an hour. Let's see if we can get to 70 miles an hour. There's an enhancement pack for this to make it sound better. It sounds okay, but I feel it could sound better. Okay, it has the same sound as the classical mobile. Yeah, pop it down in the comments below if there's any trains or routes you want me to drive. Funny enough, I was doing this route yesterday in the class 166. Slightly late, but oh well. Must have been cool though, being able to have a driver's eye view as a passenger. So I don't think the live chat is available, and I think that's because it's on YouTube Kids, so I might have to change that next time so you guys can chat. It's probably coming too quick. Wouldn't normally come into a terminus platform that quickly. It wouldn't normally be a 40 limit into a terminus platform either, so it'd normally be about 10 or 15 miles an hour, no more than that. Back vacuum brakes, come on. Ooh, that was close. I need to be careful with those vacuum brakes because they're not as good. Yeah, there's a delay between applying them. They're not like the disc brakes that we have today in the modern trains that react instantly. What a lot of people stood around here. I think this route originally it came with the original rail simulator in 2007, so it's like 15 years old. You'll need to change cab and head back to West Ealing, where another driver who is satisfied to run down the Greenford line will take over. Okay, let's go. Gear one holding is quite nicely at 9 miles an hour. Probably quite a fun train to drive in real life. Manual gearbox may be a bit of a pain, but I've got 3 minutes to get to Acton Mainline. That's lucky. Gear 3 holds us at 40.8 miles an hour. It's really handy. I suppose if you're driving these in real life, you shift well before you got to the point where you can no longer accelerate in that gear. See, we've got two people watching. Hope you're having a good day. Unfortunately, I don't think the live chat is working. We've got a 50 limit. Of course, the big advantage of having a short train is that as soon as you pass the speed limit, you can instantly accelerate. Whereas if you have a longer train, then you have to wait a lot longer to accelerate. Going backwards now. Give a save just in case game crashes. See what this thing can do. It takes a while to engage the power on this train. Totally the opposite to what it's doing outside. It's a lovely bright sunny day here. Should probably be outside rather than streaming Train Simulator, but oh well. Probably get outside later. Weather's so nice at the moment, just day after day of sunshine. Well, there's the odd cool and cloudy day, but most of the days are warm and sunny. I'm probably going to max out about 70 miles an hour, I think. I don't think this train can go much faster than that. And the RPM needle is right at the end, so yeah, I think about 70 is going to be the max this train can do. 69. We really have to start slowing down now. Otherwise we'll end up overshooting a platform. Stop. I do apologise that the quality isn't very good, but that's because my internet, my upload speed sucks, so I have to limit the upload speed to 500 kilobytes. Kilobits per second, so can go. With negative points, unfortunately. Being overtaken by the HST. Ealing, Baldwin, and then West Ealing, and that's it. Fastest train in the world. It's take a while to get going. Train more ideal for little branch lines rather than high speed lines. Imagine if probably didn't run on the Great Western Mainline in real life. A small little train. We've got this little room at the back, which is probably like a luggage storage room or something. Tiny little train. Probably seats no more than about 30-40 people. There we go then, end of the run. We're stealing about 3 minutes late, but oh well. So there we go then, that's our little run in the 1+1 2-1 bubble car it's called. It's available from the Dovetail Games store. Don't know why I failed, but okay. Missed stop, it says, but I didn't miss the stop. I still stopped there, so. Oh well. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the stream. Hope you enjoyed the video. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.